The last time India and New Zealand faced off in a World Cup was way back in the 2003 edition when 4 wickets by Zaheer Khan bundled the Kiwis out for less than 150. 16 years later, they meet again at Trent Bridge as the only two sides who are yet to taste defeat in the Cricket World Cup 2019. Thank you so much for joining us on ESPN Cricket for Match Day UK 2019 as we're joined in studio by Ajit Agarkar and also by from New Zealand. We're joined by former Kiwi pacer Kyle Mills. Guys, thank you so much. Great to have you with us on the show. Ajit, we'll start with all things India. And of course, the big news, we've already spoken about it yesterday, that is Shikhar Dhawan's out. So KL Rahul moves up. So then who slots in at number four for you?
It's a tough one. I think obviously that number four, for some reason, India's for the last 2 or 3 years, they haven't been able to decide who that guy is. And now that Rahul that picked him because of that 100 in that warm-up game has to go and open, which I think is the right position for him, or a better position for him. He's used to batting there. So that way, India is not unsettled. In my opinion, I think Vijay Shankar. I know that there'll always be a debate about Dinesh Karthik and him having the experience. But Vijay Shankar was picked in the squad as a number four. And because Rahul's, you know, ended up getting that 100 in the warm-up game, he kind of pipped him for that number four spot. He just to me, I mean, he could very well slot in at number six. If MS Dhoni, they can play MS Dhoni at four or a Kedar Jadhav even at four. And then Vijay Shankar can come at 6 or 7, depending on what the situation is. I think that 4, 5, 6, 7 are very flexible for India at the moment, which is a good thing. I think the one thing they'll obviously miss is Shikhar Dhawan because of the form that he showed in the previous game, that 100. That is, you know, Rohit and KL Rahul will have to quickly get that partnership going, because that is a critical part of India's success.
And it is that flexibility that sort of tips the scale for Vijay Shankar over a Dinesh Karthik, because you can slot him at 4, 5, 6, even with the ball then?
Yeah, I think I just, having seen him a little bit in international cricket, I think he's got different gears. I think Dinesh Karthik at times, we haven't seen too many good one-day performances from Dinesh Karthik in recent times. I think there have been some really good T20 performances. Yeah. And they, you know, Vijay Shankar had a couple of decent innings in one-day cricket, can give you a few overs if need be. If there's a bit of weather around, can bowl seam up, gives you that option, but more for his batting. I temperamentally, I'm not sure yet, because he hasn't played a lot, and we haven't seen a lot of him in international cricket, but as far as his game's concerned, I think he's got the game to succeed in that middle order.
Now, of course, with Shikhar Dhawan out, whenever you talk about India, you talk about that massive top three. That top three is not there. It's the top two, if I may refer to them as that. That being Rohit Sharma and Virat Kohli. And Virat Kohli, for one, has a fabulous record versus New Zealand. And that, for one, means that Virat Kohli is up for a big one. Just take a look at his record in ODI cricket versus New Zealand. 22 innings, more than 1,000 runs, close to 1,300 runs. Averages 68 with the bat, strike rate 96. 500s, 750s versus the Kiwis. So, fingers crossed, from an Indian perspective, Virat Kohli is coming big again.
I think he has those numbers against most teams. I think if his one-day records, anything to go by, I think what, I don't know what, 40 plus hundreds now in one-day cricket. So, those numbers will obviously, you know, it'll be more of a worry for New Zealand. I think that, I'm sure, like all teams, there'll be a lot of plans going around it. I think, and he'll be even more important now that Shikhar Dhawan's missing. Yep. He'd hope that KL Rahul does the job what Shikhar Dhawan's been doing. Rohit Sharma's already got 100 and a 50 in the two games that India's played. But he then now becomes, there's that much more added responsibility on him. And those numbers stand him in good stead against that opposition that India's up against. So I don't think there's any worry about Virat Kohli. I think once he gets in, we saw in the last game against Australia, I think was unlucky not to get his 100 because he didn't get much strike towards the end of that innings. Otherwise, would have added another 100 to his game. I think there might be a little bit more pressure. If India gets off to a start, it may not be. But if India do lose a wicket, there might be a little bit more pressure on him, considering they're missing Shikhar Dhawan.
Before a single ball is even bowled, Rohit, for you, drops anchor, has to stay till the 35th at least, go slow and then pick it up.
I think it'll all depend
Let
on
KL
how...
attack the other
Not
days.
Necessarily. I don't think you go in with sort of anything pre-planned. I think it'll depend on the condition. There's supposed to be yet some more rain.
Yes, I don't want to mention
Nottingham.
It.
Yeah, so if there is, it might be a bit challenging. The New Zealand fast bowlers have been bowling really well, so you don't want to give them the early advantage by losing too many wickets. And Rohit generally starts slow in one-day game, but you know once he's in, and if he survives those first few overs, he can get you big runs, as he's already shown. So I think you'll just approach the day Some days you just feel fluent and you start quickly. It'll all depend on the day. I don't think someone who's got 2300s knows how to approach innings.
Now, of course, when you talk about the Indian squad, you've spoken about the batsmen now. Let's talk about the bowling and the spinners in particular. Yuzvendra Chahal and Kuldeep Yadav, they've got a pretty impressive record versus New Zealand as well in ODI cricket and would be expected to do job, especially in the middle overs. Kuldeep Yadav, Yuzvendra Chahal troubled the Kiwis quite a bit, and would be expected to come in and get the breakthroughs for India.
And they've started well in both the games in the World Cup. Okay, South African batsmen weren't in great form, all slightly low on confidence, and the pitch had something in it. Against Australia as well, those middle overs. I mean, Kuldeep Yadav's figures may not show in that particular game, went for a few runs later on. But those middle overs just kept taking the rate up, didn't give too many easy boundaries, and Chahal got the wickets as well. So I'm glad that they started with him and not Jadeja, because these two, when they bowl well, will always create wicket-taking opportunities for India, and that's what you need in today's day and age. If you don't pick wickets, anything can be scored if you let two batsmen settle. So they're critical to India's plan, especially because the top two at the moment, Bumrah and Bhuvneshwar Kumar, are bowling well. You need guys following them to keep or to maintain that pressure, which these two are doing at the moment.
Kyle, the same point for you, but from a Kiwi perspective. Would you want the Kiwi batsmen to change their approach to these two leggies that India possess?
No, I think they have to back themselves and just play their natural way. So far in this tournament, the New Zealand batting order has only really been exposed to Bangladesh, and to be fair, they're put under pressure to Bangladesh. New Zealand will go with the approach that they need to trust their own game, trust their own style of play, what's worked for them in years gone by, and what has worked in the last three games. And that certainly involves around Martin Guptill at the top. Munro's into a little bit of form at the moment, but the big two wickets for India will be Kane Williamson and Ross Taylor, who without doubt are the two key batsmen for the New Zealand side. They're in a little bit of form at the moment. They're getting some nice runs and playing some nice rhythm. So for New Zealand to win this game of cricket, they will need runs out of Kane Williamson and Ross Taylor.
Ross Taylor, of course, is the only one who's got a pretty good record versus Kuldeep Yadav and Yuzvendra Chahal. Talking about your 11, Kyle, are you going with an unchanged run from the last match, or are you bringing about any changes?
It depends on fitness, because so far in this tournament, Tim Southee and Henry Nicholls have been unavailable due to fitness. Now, I'm hearing that they're both going to be fit for this game. So Kane Williamson and the coach, Gary Stead, will have a full selection of the squad. And I just wonder if this is the right opportunity to bring Tim Southee back into the starting 11. Nothing against Matt Henry. I think Matt Henry's done an excellent job those first two games. Yes, he went for a few runs against Afghanistan. But look, that can happen when the opposition become aggressive at the top of the order. What Tim Southee brings to the party is he brings a lot of variations. He brings swing. He brings nice pace. He has a lot of experience. Tim Southee has also got a good record bowling at the death and throughout the middle. So he covers quite a few bases, Tim. And look, it's going to be a long tournament, and he's going to have to come in at some stage. And he played that warm-up game against India at the Oval, and he did quite well, which were bowler-friendly conditions for a fast bowler, and he did exceptionally well there. At Trent Bridge, the first two games here have suited the fast bowlers. There's been a lot of pace and a lot of carry in that wicket. West Indies used that to good effect. And this would be a fresh wicket. If the rain stays away, because I assume the pitch has been undercover for the last day and a half or 2 days, there will be a little bit of moisture and greenness in that wicket. And those are conditions where Tim Southee excels. So that's where I'm leaning more towards Tim Southee coming in, if he's available and fit, to replace Matt Henry.
And also, of course, Matt, when you talk about that New Zealand pace battery, Lockie Ferguson, Matt Henry have really started well, been amongst the wickets. Trent Bolt, not so much, but the experienced campaigner. Now you're saying forecast also, they're saying rain possibly, which means conditions which could go in favour of someone like a Trent Bolt who has a good record versus India.
Yeah, look, it's not an English summer without rain, that's for sure. We've certainly seen that in the last couple of days. But Trent Bolt probably hasn't picked up the wickets that he would have liked in the first few games of the tournament. But he did bowl exceptionally well in both warm-up games for New Zealand. So I think he is in good form. He's just not picking up the wickets, and that will come. If he does get conditions to suit, look, he's pretty destructive when he's on song and he's got overcast conditions, Trent Bolt. And he bowls exceptionally well in partnership with Tim Southee. They, for some reason, they both complement each other really well. One going away from the right edge of the right-hand batsman, and one bringing it back in at good pace. And then, as you already mentioned, Lockie Ferguson, geez, the big improvement in Lockie, what I've seen in the last 12 months is, yes, he's got pace and he can bowl really quick, but he's got control. I've seen great control from him in these first three games at the World Cup, whereas over the past 12 to 18 months, he has been quick, but he's gone for quite a few runs because he's just sprayed it a little bit. But with that control and pace, it's a bit of a lethal combination.
So then, Kyle, it's prediction time. In all likelihood, we'll have rain play spoil sport somewhere or the other. So it might not be a full 100-over game, as they are saying right now. What's your prediction, keeping all of that in mind?
Yeah, look, well, hark back only 6 months when India were on the New Zealand shores and they gave the New Zealand side a fair old touch-up, to be fair. 3-0 was the result in that series. And I think India are the favourites for this tournament. They've got experience across the board. They've got all bases covered. So this is going to be a good line in the sand for New Zealand to see where they're at. A shortened game may come into favour for the New Zealand side. And so, look, if conditions suit, whoever wins the toss first, I think we'll have a huge advantage. And let's hope Kane Williamson wins that toss.
All right, Ajit, prediction time with you. Last word.
Yeah, I mean, look, the New Zealand record in World Cup says for itself. I think the batting still doesn't look strong apart from Kane Williamson and Ross Taylor. Just for, or hasn't been put under too much pressure. Just if you compare two teams on paper before the game starts, I think India is a much more balanced team. Mm. I'm sure a lot more confident in spite of New Zealand having won three games. You'd never take anything for granted, but at this point, India are clear favourites in my opinion.
Ajit Agarkar, Kyle Mills, guys, thank you so much for joining us, as we are looking ahead to India versus New Zealand at Trent Bridge. And Rain Gods, if you're listening, stay away. We want to see a 100-over game. It promises to be a cracker. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave your comments in the comments section below. Click on the bell icon for notifications.